So this video is all about gear theory, and in this video we will calculate gear ratio of a transmission system. So before calculating gear ratio, we have to know gear pitch. So gear pitch is the number of teeth per given unit of pitch diameter. So for example, we have a gear here, and 6 inch is the diameter of this gear, and we have 42 teeth on this gear. So gear pitch will be 42 divided by 6. So 42 is the number of teeth and 6 inch is the diameter of the gear. So dividing this will result into 7, and the pitch is 7. Gears must have the same pitch to operate together. So if two gears are matched together, and their pitch will be same. So we have two gears matched here, and both of these gears are rotating in opposite direction. So this is our drive gear and this is driven gear. So we have 2 meter of diameter of this drive gear and 4 meter diameter of driven gear. So we will notice that this drive gear is rotating at 200 rpm, which generates a torque of 25 Nm, while the driven gear having 4 meter diameter is rotating at 100 rpm and generating more torque, twice torque than the drive. There is variation in rpm and torque because there is a gear ratio. There is a gear ratio between these two operating gears. So we will calculate now gear ratio. Now let's calculate a gear ratio of a transmission system. We have input gear. So we have input here to the A, to gear A, and the output, the driven gear, is A dash. After that, A dash and B is rotating at the same speed because they are on the same shaft and rotating on the same speed. B is drive gear for B dash, and B and A dash is rotating at the same speed, but B has 15 teeth, B dash has 35 teeth, A has 20 teeth, and A dash has 40 teeth. So the input goes to A, then A dash, then B, then B dash, and then output is taken to the shaft. To calculate the gear ratio, we have to divide the number of teeth of the driven gear to the drive gear. So in first case, we have driven gear A dash and drive gear A. A dash divided by A, and we are multiplying B dash by B, because B dash is driven gear and B is drive gear, so B dash by B, and we are multiplying because these are all connected. Because these are connected in the series, so gear ratio is also going to be multiplied. So putting these values in this equation, we will get 40 divided by 20 and 35 divided by 15. So we will get the gear ratio of 4.67:1. So this is the gear ratio that we calculated for this transmission system in the current gear engagement. So if we are going to calculate gear ratio of reverse gear, we will see that there is no effect of idle gear, as the driven gear and drive gear is idle gear, which cancels the numerical values, and so that's why there is no effect of idle gear, as this is the common between the two gears. So that's how gear ratios are calculated, and thanks for watching.